سبيل الدموع سبيل مريح تنا أدى يا صاحي كي تستريح وبث الدعاء الخفي الصريح.
Third point is the question. The question itself should be posed clearly with all the necessary details. If it is written or typed or text messaged or used some other social media outlet to send the message, then it should be reasonably grammatically sound to allow the Mufti to understand the question. It may require the Mufti to correspond with the questioner, so a means of contact should be supplied, so that he can contact as and when he chooses. The context for each question is very important, as the response is based upon the context. So just giving the question without a context would not allow the Mufti to be able to fairly and adequately, and to be honest, accurately respond to your query. If the question is posed by phone or when the Mufti is outside of his darlifta, then the individual should not expect an immediate response, as the Mufti could be preoccupied or busy with some other engagement. And even if he is available in his darlifta, then again he may be preoccupied, and as a result he may give a time for the questioner to call back or will take their details and respond at a later time. We must be patient with that regard. We can be somewhat impatient by posing a question and expecting an immediate response. I will touch upon that in time as well as we discuss the question. It's also a good habit and good etiquette to highlight the speed of response you require. This does not necessarily mean that the Mufti will respond in that time, but at least he can decide that if he's available to respond to your query, or he may say to you that I don't have the time frame that you request, I cannot meet that time frame. So some speeds of responses could be immediate, which, as it says, immediate is within at the point of contact. Could be urgent, which you could say is within 24 hours. Standard, approximately a week. And it could be at your earliest convenience, which is whenever the individual or the Mufti is available. It's not appropriate or good manners to continuously harass the Mufti for a response. He will usually have other responsibilities, not only answering queries, but possibly teaching, lecturing, researching, writing, and many other responsibilities. So this is, we have to take into consideration his busy schedule. And bear in mind that even the simplest of questions can take hours looking through pages of text. So it's not as though we get a simple question and we expect a response immediately. In other words, a quick question does not guarantee a quick response. And you hear that many a time, either on text message or at the beginning of a call, I've got a quick question. And as I respond, yes, you might have a quick question, but I don't necessarily have a quick answer. So in other words, a quick question does not guarantee a quick response. The question should not stay within the question boundaries or parameters. It is not appropriate to set parameters for the Mufti. So some individuals may state, give me evidence from the Quran and Sunnah and please respond to XYZ. That's twofold. One is the parameters that we're basing upon the Mufti himself. And secondly, the reason is that the majority of the Muftis will follow a particular madhab. And as he follows a particular madhab, he will give you answers from the reputable books of his fiqh from his madhab. It's not that he will go directly to the verses of the Quran, and it is not that he will go directly to a hadith, because the books of fiqh are based upon them. And I do touch upon this topic in one of my videos, which hopefully, inshallah, will be made public in the coming weeks, with respect to, do we go directly to the Quran and the Sunnah, or do we follow the position of one of the four schools? And finally, the answer is specifically for the questioner, once the answer is obtained. And it's not wise to share with someone, as that context could be different. And if their context is different, and their response is given bearing in mind your context, then their answer will not fit with their particular query. And also, we should try to act upon the advice of the Mufti as he has detailed. It's quite pointless to pose the question, and once we get a response, to not act upon it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us all the ability to act upon how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wishes from us to act and requires us to act. Ameen. Wa akhiru da'wana. And alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
يسعك الفضاء الرحيم.